Hello and welcome to this quick tutorial where I show you how to import your notes from Notion into Obsidian. So what you want to do is open up Notion, go to the notes database or wherever all of your notes are located. So for me, I would go to my notes page here and then I would go to my master notes database. So wherever the majority, and you can do this for all the databases if there are multiple ones within your Notion. It just makes it easier if you have a main hub or database like this here. Once you're at the database that you want to import, so for me it's all of my notes, I want to click on the three dots, horizontal dots in the upper right hand corner, and I want to go down to where you see export. So if we click on export, then this box comes available to us here. Now, when exporting from Notion, it's going to export as a zip file. Now, because Obsidian is a Markdown format, you would assume that you would automatically just do it into Markdown. And this does work, but I've found that I've run into more problems doing it in Markdown as if I just did it in HTML. So I would choose HTML. If you don't get the results you're looking for, then hit the drop down again and do this process over and choose Markdown to find out which one works best for you and the best results. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose HTML and a couple of options here. Include databases, so current view or default view. I would do current view. That way you know exactly what you're getting. Include content, you wanna include everything. Or if there are files and images within your notes, you don't want to include those files and or images. I would just do everything. That way you get the full aspect of what your notes are. And then you want to include subpages. I would check this box here to include the subpages. Now, I do not want it to create a folder for all of my subpages because what happens is if you have multiple subpages or a bunch of subpages like I have, it'll create a ton of folders within Obsidian. So I just uncheck that option to just give me a massive list of my notes and then I can filter them and sort them where I want them when I get them into Obsidian. You can choose how you want. This is just personal preference. And then if you're working with collaborators, you can export the comments as well. I'm not going to do that. And then I'm going to click the blue button here that says export. When you do that, it'll show you the progress here of the exporting, how many pages have been exported, and then it also lets you know that there will be an email sent to your associated email with your Notion account letting you know that you can download and that the export is complete. I'm actually going to close out of this now and hop over to Obsidian. Once that file has exported to your computer, you then want to hop over to Obsidian, log into your account, and you want to install a community plugin called Importer. So what you want to do is click on the settings or gear icon here next to your account name, and then you're going to go under options to community plugins. You want to make sure that community plugins are enabled, and then when you are ready to go, you can turn them on and reload. And we're going to go ahead and click the browse button here next to community plugins. Now, under the search bar, I want you to search for a plugin called Importer. It's the one here. It's got hundreds of thousands of installs, and it lets you know you can import data from Notion, Evernote, all of the common players here. You want to select that there, and you want to install, click install, and then you'll have to click enable. So two options here. You got to click install, and then once it installs, you got to click enable. It'll be right here under the name. Once you've done that, the plugin will show up on the left-hand sidebar. So where you normally create new notes, open new notes, graph view, things like that, you should see a new icon that looks like this that says Open Importer. Click on the Open Importer option and it'll open the option to import data into Obsidian. Now, file format, very important. Select the drop-down note, go ahead and go to Notion, which is going to be a zip file. And then you'll want to choose the file to import. So I'm going to choose file. And under my downloads here, I have a file right here that is a zip file, and this is the one that I want to import. You can either double click or click and click open, letting you know what that file is here. Output folder, you can give this a name. I'm just going to name it Notion so I can sort accordingly once all of these notes have been imported into my Obsidian. Once you've done that, it says save parent pages in subfolders. I wouldn't do that, because again, this is going to create a massive list of subfolders and it's just easier to sort. But again, you do you, whatever you want to do. And then I uncheck single line breaks. But again, if it's something you want, you can do that. And then click the blue import button here. It'll let you know what it has imported. Go ahead and click done. And now we can see over here on the left-hand side, this little folder was created with all of my Notions, with my master Notion, you know, note database, and here they are. Here are all of my notes. I can click into them and they work just like they would. And then you just go through, click and hold, drag them where you want them within your Obsidian, and you're good to go. And lastly, I'll show you all of the images. Like, here's a attachment for a schedule for my daughter's baseball or t-ball league. This was an attachment in one of the notes. Those will show as separate files here underneath the notes that was imported. But if you go and select them and then go to Shift Select, you can actually just right click and delete all of those because they're still going to show up within the note. That's just going to have them saved as a separate entity over on the left hand sidebar. And I don't like the way that looks or the way it feels when I'm trying to find my stuff within Obsidian. So I went ahead and delete that. That's it. That's how you do it. If you have any questions about doing this, put them in the comment section below. If it helped, like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video.